Have you ever read the comment on Fragrantica about like cheapies and stuff? It's so funny. Like, people complain about longevity and about the fact that it smells generic so much. And I'm like, what do you expect? You paid like £20 for it. This is why I'm not doing those videos quite often. I really don't want to get in a debate like, nah, Clemens, this doesn't perform. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers, this is Clémence. I'm talking about fragrance. Welcome back. Today's video, we're talking about 15 bismuth fragrances cheap for men. Just a little reminder, it's not groundbreaking. You're gonna pay for less, so I think put your expectation down. However, this is, for me, the best I could find in there. So, enjoy! My number one is Zara Rich Warm and Addictive. This is one of my classics. I usually always include it. You can't go wrong with this one. Slightly coconutty, vanilla-like, very smooth, very cozy scent, and a great performer. I actually had many, many compliments when I'm wearing that, which is quite surprising because it costed me like £12 or something. Usually it gives on a man something like quite like sensual, reassuring, I would say, for a lady. That's the reassuring one. Obviously, guys, I'm not gonna spend like ages talking about each of those fragrances. It's not like I'm talking about vanilla from Madagascar or... Number two is Dunhill Icon. I know you've got the Absolute, but I actually prefer the Icon Classic, and I think you're gonna do a best deal if you go for the Classic. The bottle is super luxurious to me, which is really surprising. It's really heavy, so it's probably not the one you're gonna take for traveling or anything like that. It smells like a generic men's fragrance, but still it's got like something a bit special. I think it's the combination of a lot of pepper with neroli, that orangey like feeling. It does give me a vibe of like a bike, something like Terre d'Hermessy or something like that, which is nice. I would probably wear it for more daytime. For me, it's a great pick for office. Performance is amazing. I think definitely you can last all day with something like this. It's very clean, it's very classic, like you can't go wrong with it. So yeah, definitely a good investment. My next one is Stash from SGP, one of my best cheapie ever. It's supposed to be for women, but come on. It's strong, guys. It's really strong, meaning like you've got a lot of like woody note, quite intense, and a very present fruity note at the start. Like, it's very punchy in your face. The opening make me think like of some kind of like a Paco Rabanne that you get on your face.
Okay.
I initially bought it because it was supposed to be like a dupe of Santal Blush from Tom Ford, which is one of my favorite fragrances. It is not. It's much more fruitier. It's not as softer. It does have this very unique touch. It's not something very generic to me. A bit more of a luxurious vibe to me. So, surprising. Next one is my Lacoste Boosters. I really love it because my dad used to wear it, so I get like great memories of it. It does smell that kind of like generic, like fragrance for men again. Shower gel feel to it. Very, very clean. I really love it. Like, honestly, if you want something that projects a lot and smells really masculine, a bit alpha male, like, this is probably a good one for you. And slightly a minty, and that's why it smells that clean. You have a minty note in there. If you don't like mint, it's probably not for you. It's around £30, I think, in the UK at least. My next one is Ferragamo. I never know how to say it. Ferragamo. Got it. I think got it. Yomo. Ambery, woody, kind of like sweetie fragrance. So really great for the winter. I think we all like something like a bit more warm, cozy for winter. It is not really formal. Oppositely, for example, from Dunhill, that is a bit more formal. This one, for me, is a bit like more inviting, charming. I would say probably like something like more like a dinner date or something like that. A bit more seductive and a bit more inviting. I remember smelling like few time on a man and being like, wow, the guy like... actually like smell something nice, and you know, you want to get closer and you want to create that intimacy with the guy, so good deal. Next one is Bentley for men intense. I don't know, I've done that the other day. I said smell instead of smell. What the hell, I'm doing poetry right now. Did you hear that? Oh gosh. Bentley for men, for me,
Women.
I did try that quite recently, actually, like everyone was talking about it. Before I came to the UK, I never heard about Carl's company creating fragrance. Like, for me, that was the most cheapest thing you could wear. And I actually, like, tried this one. And I was like, man, that's great. It's like a woody, a spicy tone, so very dark, like having like a lot of strong character to give that very mysterious vibe, you know, like very seductive. If you like a slightly boozy accord, you're gonna like that because there's a bit of that rum touch. A chill, cozy winter cocktail in the evening with a girl when you want to impress her but don't show her that you're still very classy, you know, you don't want to get to the sex right now. I have this one. Next one is Issey Miyake and it's Nuit 17. It smells really synthetic for me. You can get it for £22, so I think who cares if it smells synthetic or not. It's a bit the gothic of the ones. It does have that incense-y touch in there with grapefruit, like quite fruity and fresh, juicy, but then it all goes down to very dark ingredient. Ebony wood that is always smelling like the darkest of the wood, incense, everything that is really dark will be in this fragrance basically. The first hour it's intoxicating and then after is rubbish. Super heady, super beast when you apply it the first hour and then it's like boop. Just to let you know, it's a beast mode for an hour. No, to be fair, like I really enjoy it. Like, next one is Burberry London. How could I not include my favorite cheapie? For women is London, for men it's always London. It's a bit like a Christmas in a bottle, sweet tobacco scent. That's why a lot of people say it's Christmas. It's just because there's cinnamon. £21 on All Beauty. I've seen that lastly, so really good deal. Is Boss Bottle Eau de Parfum. So I'm not usually the best fan of Boss fragrances, but if we are into the cheap fragrance, I'm like, yeah, the Eau de Parfum is really good. Kind of inoffensive smell, but at the same time, it's kind of a fragrance you always go to. It's like you're dump rich. I don't know what to wear, and I'm like, duh, can't be bothered today. This is the one I'm gonna go for. I know it's gonna last. I know it's gonna get great impression of someone. Is that really unique? No. Does it really get some, like, a lot of compliment? Yes. Usually the most common smell or usually the best compliment getter. Well, that's what I thought on myself. Plus, it's got a bit like some kind of a uniqueness with the apple note. And apple note, like, gives that, you know, slightly a juicy but not too fresh accord. And that's why I think I really like it. But yeah, classic. My next one is Azzaro Wanted by Night. I really don't want to smell that again on a man. But I'm happy to advise it to you. I just bought this one for the next because I really enjoyed it. And now whenever I smell it, I'm like, dah. I found it on All Beauty at £31. Again, do the conversion dollar, but it won't be like a crazy amount. It's a bit like a spicy oriental fragrance. Don't come at me if I say oriental. Oriental as in the ingredients that are in the oriental part of the world. That's it, just a location, okay? Like mainly like vanilla notes, so very cozy, very warm. Again, it's something that is not really offensive, but if you like a vanilla note, I really find this fragrance sexy. It's a bit more heady, so be careful with this one. Always try it because I know that sometimes the vanilla is very opulent. A little bit more party to me, like, you know, this vibe. It's got a strong orangey undertone, and that's why I feel that some people are like, ah, it's heady. Next one is Dracar Noir by Guy Laroche. How can I not talk about Dracar Noir? Like in France, it was like, if someone was wearing Dracar Noir, it was like, why are you doing that to yourself? You know, like, because it's extremely strong. It was reputed to be the strongest one in the Sephora in my city. So everyone would be like, oh no, not trying this. There was this person being like, oh, he's so weak and stuff. I'm like, what? Literally every time I smell a Dracar Noir, it was from very far away. Trust me, like all the room is intoxicating and probably like someone would kick you out of the room. Be careful with this one, like spray a little bit. For me, it smells like the classic masculine vibe. For me, a bit macho. The guy that wants to smell a bit aftershave like, because there's lavender, you know, juniper, you know, this green undertone, very mossy, but with a bit of lavender. So it's definitely like a barbershop type of fragrance. If you're meeting a girl for the first time, please don't wear this. Please don't do that to yourself. I probably wear it like on a daytime, you know, like when you're going out with friends, or, you know, like you're gonna do something casual, really. Like, is Eros Versace. So this is not for my taste. I'm including it now because I think objectively it's a great teenager fragrance, a clubbing scent. Vanilla is blended with some like fresh notes, so it gives me that vibe of a Paco Rabanne and stuff like that, so a very party boy. I'm really selling it, am I? £25. It's genuinely a nice fragrance. I really like it. I think just the target is young people, clubbing type of evening. And that's it. Like, if a guy wear that to a date though with me, I would be like, oh my god, like he's too young for me. challenge me, man.
Challenge accepted.
No. My next one is Mercedes Club Black. Mercedes-Benz, you know, why do they keep this name like so long? Like, oh gosh, it's an amber fragrance and I love my amber fragrance. You can find it like for £34 or something. Smooth. It's the coziest one of the list, with rich, warm and addictive. It's really like leaner to me, like a little bit sensual, Netflix and chill, plus, I would say. Maybe a cinema date or something like that. Or someone who just like want to go to work with something like more quite creamy and sensual tone. The little particularity with this one is got like a tad little bit of smoky tones. Wouldn't match it to a Mercedes. Probably like go for MFK to mark your Mercedes, but whatever. Last one is Zara Sandalwood. I do love my Zaras. I have to say they smell overly synthetic and whatever, but Sandalwood is actually my ultimate favorite for men. A bit that vibe of Santal 33 from Le Labo. Ultra synthetic sandalwood, very powdery and very ultra soft with the iris that gives even more powderiness. So it's slightly like floral woody, and I do love that on a man. I think it's always very romantic to me, very charming. It's nice for daytime as well, but I just find it really romantic. It does make me feel a bit like of that iris touch in a Dior Homme, for example, that I love. And you know, it's one of my favorite fragrances for men. So honestly, I just find it so classy. And when I smell like a little bit of a flower on a man, I'm like, oh my god, this guy is original and also... it's got a bit of sensitivity. Of course, like girls, they do like bad boy, get you on that. But I don't know, this one's got everything. Darkness, but we know that you can be sensitive and you can, you know. Sorry, man, it must be really difficult for you. Well, that's it for my list. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know if you have any other cheapies. Like, I'm always up for cheapies. Like, why not? But I have to say, like, again, it's not something that you will see quite often on my channel. Just because I'm really into quality of ingredient. That's what usually appeals to me. So I'm usually more into my niche fragrances. That's true. I feel, you know, like it's something else, you know, like makes you feel unique, and I'm happy to wear amazing creation from perfumers. I feel there's more to say, there's more of a history behind, there's more of a, everything that I like about fragrance, really. But yeah, well, that's my vibe. You've got my YouTube account in the description box if you want to support me. It's always appreciated to support the channel. Next buy is microphone, so I want a good one. I want a really good one that can be quite mobile for me to do my vlogs. And subscribe if you're not subscribed yet, because I see you're not a lot to be subscribed and watching my video. Not nice, not nice, mate. I will see you soon. Bye now.